أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, most merciful, I greet you all, my dear viewers, in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be with you all. In the past few episodes, we mentioned the fact that although the glorious Quran is basically a book of guidance to man in areas that cannot be correctly addressed by man, such as the area of faith, the area of acts of worship, the area of the moral code, and the area of the code of transactions with others, yet this noble book contains more than 1200 cosmic verses that speak about this universe and many of its components. And these verses do not come down in the context of being pieces of scientific information per se. They come down as a testimony to the might, knowledge, and wisdom of the Creator, to the supremacy of the Creator above all His creation, to the oneness of this great Creator, and it actually become a very suitable address to the people of our time, this era of great scientific and technological advancements unparalleled before in human history. And we mentioned that one of the great scientific facts that came in the Noble Quran is the statement that we are living in a steadily expanding universe, a fact that came to human knowledge only in the first third of the 20th century. Secondly, stemming from this expansion, science came to speak about the fact that if we go back against time with this expansion, everything in that universe, space, time, matter, and energy will coalesce together into a tiny entity, which they call the initial singularity. And they claim that this initial singularity was in an unstable state, and that's why it exploded, changed into a cloud of smoke, and from that smoke, everything we observe in the current universe were created. And it's really amazing that in the same Quranic chapter, chapter number 21, Surah Al-Anbiya, we find at the beginning the verse that reads, أَوَلَمْ يَرَى الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ كَانَتَا رَتْقًا فَفَتَقْنَاهُمَا وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ أَفَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Having the unbelievers seen that both the heavens and the earth were an initial singularity, which we did the clove asunder. And then we, towards the end of the chapter, verse number 104, we find what we find another statement, verse number 104, that speaks about the big crunch. So we have the big bang in verse number 30 in chapter 21st, and we find the big crunch towards the end of this chapter. يوم نطوي السماء كطي السجل للكتب كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده وعدا علينا إن كنا فاعلين. The day will come when we will roll up the heavens like a scroll, rolled up for books, completed, even as we produced the first creation, so we shall produce a new one. A promise we have undertaken, truly we shall fulfill. And of course, the fact that we find a hint towards the big bang at the beginning of that chapter, and another hint to the big crunch at the end of the same chapter, is enough testimony to every sane person that this book cannot be the work of man. It is the divine word in its divine purity. And even astronomers who believe in the Big Bang and the Big Crunch disagree amidst themselves. Some say that we are living in an open universe that will keep on expanding forever. And others say that we are living in a closed universe that where the expansion has to come to an end, and then gravity will collect they observe the universe into an initial singularity similar to the initial singularity from which it was created. And even those who believe in the Big Crunch disagree amidst themselves. Some of them say that this is the end of everything. Others say that this is a continuous process, explosion followed by crunch, or Big Bang followed by crunch, crunch followed by Big Bang, and so on. And both groups are actually scared of meeting their creator. And this critical issue was only explained by the glorious Quran by a single verse that reads, يوم نطوي السماء كطي السجل للكتب كما بدأنا أول خلق نعيده وعدا علينا إن كنا فاعلين. And then the Quran reads, يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار. The earth will be replaced by another earth and the firmament by other firmaments and will be resurrected from the new earth. And strangely enough, if this new earth has to be much bigger than the current earth and it has to contain all our remnants because we will be resurrected from our remnants by certain rain that comes from the sky. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is quoted to have said, كل بني آدم يبلى إلا عظما واحدا هو عجب الذنب منه خلق وفيه يركب يوم القيامة. The body of a human being will be completely worn out except a single bone, which is the coccyx, the fused vertebrae at the end of the vertebral column. And it has been scientifically proved that all the organs are actually created from this particular coccyx, and this coccyx cannot be destroyed. Neither heating, nor boiling, nor crushing can destroy it. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is quoted to have said, ما بين النفختين أربعون ثم ينزل الله ماء من السماء فينبتون كما ينبت البقل. Between the two blows, after the first blow, every living being will die. The second blow, every dead person will be resurrected. And he said, ينزل الله ماء من السماء, Allah will allow certain rain to come down from the sky. فينبتون كما ينبت البقل. They will be resurrected in the form similar to the process of plantation, seed plantation. And that's why we find in the glorious Quran a testimony to the fact that this worldly life is not the end of everything. This is a temporary stage. On the basis of our role on it, we will be rewarded by eternity in paradise forever, or we'll be actually punished by staying in hellfire forever. And that's why the verse reads, يوم تبدل الأرض غير الأرض والسماوات وبرزوا لله الواحد القهار. The day will come when the earth will be replaced by another earth and the firmaments will be replaced by other firmaments, and that we will be resurrected from the new earth. And we can see in this verse in Surah Ibrahim the real answer to the end of this existence, which is highly debated by many scholars of our time. The end will definitely come. This worldly life is not eternity. We can see everything around us dying, human beings die, animals, plants, stars, planets, galaxies, everything, testifying to the fact that this is a very temporary existence that is not eternity at all. And eternity will come after the destruction of this worldly life, of this current universe, and then the creation of a different earth and a different firmament other than what we observe today. And by this, we come to the end of this episode. And I would love to thank you for listening and invite you for critically reading the glorious Quran, even in the translation. Although I admit clearly that the divine permeation, which we can observe in the Arabic text of the glorious Quran can never be transferred to any translation into any other language. But read the Quran in any language, in any translation, and judge for yourself whether this is the word of God or the word of man. And until we meet in the coming episode, I thank you for listening and pray for your best, greeting you in our Islamic way. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, mercy, and blessings be with you all.